If you have your Bible with you, check out the Bibles. Matthew, the 14th chapter. Matthew, the 14th chapter. A very familiar with text. 25th through 25th, 28th, and 29th.
Amen.
25th verse, 28th verse, and 29th verse. Reading from the Easy Version Bible. During the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went out to them and walked on the water. Mm-hmm. Lord, if this you, Peter replied, tell me to come to you out on the water. Mm-hmm. Come, he said, and Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, came towards Jesus. Mm-hmm. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you once again to become in a name, to come proclaiming that word. And as we proclaim that word, we pray your word will prick our hearts and our minds, that we may change from where we were the day we became and be better. Better soldier, better Christian, better mothers and fathers, better pastor, better leaders of the church. We pray that we won't be the same as we level, we'll be better, greater. And tell the story about you. In your name, let the words of my mouth and the midst of my heart and set my sight. Oh Lord, you're my rock, you're my redeemer, we pray. Amen. The choir of instruction will come back preaching the word of God. The choir of instruction will come back proclaiming the word of God.
Yeah.
God on says praying time.
Praying time.
Every time you pray is praying time. And prayer will change that. You don't believe this, try praying. Praying will change that.
Thank you, Jesus.
Peter, Lord, is it you? Peter replied, then tell me to come to you on the water.
Amen.
Jesus said to Peter, Peter got down out of the boat. Mm-hmm. Walked on the water.
Mm-hmm.
And came toward Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to walk, you got to get out of the boat. If you want to walk, you have to get out of
the boat.
That's the boat.
The boat.
Uh-huh.
Here is one of our lessons today. Matthew is the author of our story. He tells us that Jesus on the water walking. Peter expressed he wanted to walk on the water with Jesus.
Mm-hmm. Well,
Jesus commanded the disciples to go across to the other side of the lake. And Jesus went to pray as they went on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus commanded the disciples to go get on the boat and go across. And while they are on the boat, probably relaxing, probably smiling, probably rejoicing, the scripture say a violent storm came up. And the storm began to rock the boat. And it got cloudy. Jesus approached the disciple by walking on the water. And when they saw something walking, the Bible said they got scared. They were terrified. They thought that it was a ghost. Jesus assured them it was he. And Peter saw him and began to want to walk on the water. There's a lesson that Jesus is teaching us. Here's the lesson. Jesus used a storm to get our attention. Here in this lesson, the disciples were tired. They were worn out. And Jesus sent them on a boat for relaxation, for peace of mind.
Come on.
Have you been there?
All right.
Have you been there when you go on vacation, when you go somewhere and you think you left all your trouble behind you? And all of a sudden, a storm rise. We learn that Jesus is in the midst of the storm.
Thank you, Lord.
He's in the bed. The question comes, why would Jesus send his disciples out on a boat knowing that a storm would rise?
Come on.
One is that we must do what the Lord tells us to do.
That's right.
Do not get so far in your life that you think the storm is going to pass you by. You will not do anything great until you get out of the boat.
Come on.
In the storm, we learn that God is in the midst of the storm.
That's right.
Here in this lesson, do what the Lord tells us to do.
Uh-huh.
We got to trust God.
Yes. Yes.
We can't doubt the Lord. We got to trust the Almighty God. God told his disciples, Jesus told his disciples to get on the boat. So they obeyed Jesus. Sometimes the storm comes because we disobey God. Sometimes we have storms in our life because we simply disobey God. We will face storms in our life no matter who we are. Jesus had just fed the 5,000. And they were excited by following Jesus. So Jesus simply told them to get on the boat. Here Jesus, the Messiah, the leader of the valley, telling the disciples simply to get on the boat. Now the question is, Jesus did not go with them. It was somebody. That was somebody. Jesus didn't go with them. Jesus stayed back to pray, but he told them to get on the boat. We must trust God.
All right.
We must trust what God has asked us to do and not doubt the word of God. As Christians, we must understand that storm, we cannot detour storm. I don't care what we are, who we are. Storm will always come. Many times folks think they can get by the storm by running away. We can't run away from storm. We are not exempted from storm as Christians. Storm will find you. Mm-hmm.
Yes,
somebody. I don't care where you are, I care who you may be. Storm will find you. When you think that you have gotten away from a storm will find you.
Yes, sir.
The boat is now in the midst of the sea, tossed and then turning the waves. In the fourth hour. In the fourth hour. No light. No moon. Everything is dark. Disciples are panicking in the boat. Jesus began to walk out on the water. They heard something. They saw something. But they weren't sure what they saw. But the voice of Jesus said, "It is I." Hello, somebody. Hello, somebody. Hello, somebody. Have you ever been in a storm? And when your storm comes in, when you get connected to God, there's comfort knowing that God is by your side. We might not know what's coming. We might not know how bad the storm is. But one thing we know that Jesus is by our side. Be of good cheer. Do not be afraid. Trusting in God in the midst of your storm. Trust God. Do not get so that you get caught up in the storm. We get caught up in the storm. We get caught up in the storm. When storms come, instead of looking at Jesus, we look at the storm. When trouble comes, instead of looking at Jesus, we look at the trouble. When sickness comes, instead of looking at Jesus, we look at sickness. seeking God and broke you through. How many ever had trouble and God broke you through? We must recognize with God and recognize that God has all power and God can do anything that he wants to do.
All right.
And when the storm get rough and seem like we can't see our way through, we must hold on.
Hold on.
Hold on. Hold on. Be not afraid. Hold on. God unchanging. Yeah. You must trust God.
Yes, sir.
Thy I am God. I am the lily of the valley.
Yes,
I am the bright and morning star.
Yes, sir.
Trust God. And put your hand in God's hand. One of the problems we have that many Christians who claim to be Christian,
All right.
Who confess with their mouth, but they show things the other way. When trouble comes, they don't trust God. They trust everything else except God. I want you to know if we try God, God will make a way somehow. God will meet you in your storm. God will meet you in your trouble. God will meet you in your crisis. If we just hold on to God's unchanging hand. Trust God. Do not forget what God has done for you. Put your hand in God's hand. Everything will be all right. No matter what problem you may have on your job. No matter what problem you may have in your family. Be of good cheer. Be of good cheer. The Lord will make a way. Peter. They are spoken disciples. Heard the voice of Jesus.
Come on now.
Lord, is it really you, Lord? Lord, is it really you out there on the water? Lord, is it really you out there walking on the water? The Lord told me, yes, it is I. It is me who's walking on the water. He said, Lord, is it really you? He let me come and walk on the water with you. Can I get a witness? The Lord told Peter, come on, Peter. Come on, Peter. Peter stood up on the boat. Can't you see the other 11 disciples trying to convince Peter to sit down? Can't you see other disciples? You got some folks are no naysayers. Some folks got negative attitude. Trying to discourage Peter from walking on the water. Can I get a witness? You got some Peter happy living in their comfort zone. They don't want to walk on the water. They good being just where they are. Somebody say, yeah. But if you want to walk, you got to get out the boat. So the Lord told Peter, come on, Peter. I can imagine in Peter's mind, he was still worried about those on the boat, trying to convince him not to get on, not to walk on the water. And as Peter go toward the water, he stand on the edge of the boat and put his feet in the water. And they doubt Peter. Have you ever been there sometime? Somebody dare you do this and dare you do that. And Peter stuck his feet back in. Ain't going out there. The Lord said, come on, Peter. Come on, Peter. Walk on the water. And Peter got out there. Put his feet in the water. Someone said, Peter, every time we turn around, you always want to be seen. Everybody want to see you. And Peter stuck his feet back on the boat. The Lord said, Peter, come on, Peter. Come out on the water. Peter stuck his feet out the third time. He started walking on the water. Ain't God all right? Come on, Peter. Walk towards me, Peter. Peter started walking. As he started walking to God, the disciples on the boat was probably mad at Peter. But let me tell you what Peter did. Peter got so he turned around and took his eye with Jesus. He said, look at me, disciples. I'm walking on the water. Look at me, disciples. He started boasting about himself. Did not talk about the power of God. The Bible said, can I preach to church? As he walked on the water, when he took his eye with Jesus, he began to sink in the water. But thank God, there's a man by the name of Jesus who can pick you up and turn you around. He said, Lord, save me. The Lord reached his hand out and grabbed Peter. I want you to know, have you been saved by the Lord before? How many of you been saved by God? He picked you up and turned you around, clean you up from your sin. Thank God that Jesus is my rock in a winter land. He's my shelter in a time of storm. He's my Alpha and Omega. He's my rock. If you want to walk, if you want to walk, St. Peter,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Stand up.
That's right. That's right.
Stand up.
Yes.
Your first faith is to stand up. Don't you never think they're going to be people who are going to try to discourage you. Oh, y'all don't get me. The same people that discourage you are the same people who ain't doing nothing at all now. Peter didn't mind about what they said about him. You all want to be seen. He was working for the kingdom of God. And when you're trying to build up God's kingdom, you got to shake it off and pack it on in. Tell somebody. You got to shake that stuff off and pack it on in. And then when you get out the boat and you start walking on water, don't think you did it on your own. Help somebody. I need a prayer church now. Don't think because you walk on the water, you all are dead in a bag of potato chips. You ain't get it by yourself. You got it from the help of the Lord. Don't think you didn't do it by yourself.
That's right. Amen.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank
you, Lord. Amen.
And when you've been saved,
come on now. Thank you, Jesus.
The last thing about the lesson here, when you are saved, when you are sinking deep in sin, well, y'all don't hear me this morning. When you are sinking deep in sin, and you can't let sin go, you got your hand on sin and trying to serve God and sin at the same time, you gotta let it go. Have God saved you? Have you been saved by the Holy Spirit? That's different than coming. And I remind folks all the time, when I was young, I came because my grandmother said I had to come. I had to come. You live in a house, you had to come over and give yourself 12 years old.
Oh,
You had to get them from the church and give yourself to Christ. But I wasn't saved.
Come on now.
I was not saved. When I joined the church, I was not saved. Just because you've been baptized, that doesn't mean that you saved.
Come on now.
Just because you got sprinkled and you got wet, and they dried you off, you still a wet devil. If you have not been converted, ooh, hallelujah, somebody. If you have not been converted with the Holy Spirit, yeah, the Holy Spirit has not converted you. And what converts you is that I'm not the same as I was yesterday. I am today. Hello, somebody. Let me say it again. Let me say it again. I'm not the same as I was yesterday that I am today. See, when I'm saying mean that if me and Brother Buckland had an argument 10 years ago, and on the fifth year I got saved. And I'm still mad at Brother Buckley. And I got saved. And every time I see Brother Buckley, I go the other way. I can't shake his hand. Am I saved? Second thing, when you say, children imitate us.
Yes,
Angel. Let me say it again now. Let me say it again now. Children imitate what we do. This pastor will pass in the church, and his daughter invites some friends over to the house. He was upstairs arguing. And the pastor was trying to get his sermon ready for Sunday. And they got louder and louder. So the pastor finally went upstairs and told them, why are you arguing? These are your friends. Why do you keep arguing? See, like, the louder and louder you get. The little girl said, Dad, we act just like the church do to you.
Thank you.
It's like the church do. They argue all the time. They want to be hitting that. We have to teach our children about the Spirit of God. That's why children give up so easy, because we give up. That's why children don't hold on to God's hand, because we don't hold on God's hand like we used to do.
All right.
That's why children don't see us pray no more.
Come on.
My grandma would get on knees every night. I don't care what it was. She's going to pray.
That's right.
She's going to bend down on knees. She's going to pray. Right. Every night she's going to knees. She's going to pray. She got up in the morning, speak the Bible. She's going to read about my grandma going to do that. But they don't see that. We don't sit down and have dinner together no more.
No, you don't.
We don't have family dinner.
No.
I invited my mother's over to Thanksgiving dinner in Orangeburg. And while we was eating, everybody, we all had our cell phone texting somebody. We don't do stuff like we used to.
No, we don't.
Because we are sinking deep in sin. But you want to walk. How many want to walk? How many want to walk this morning? How many want to walk in the name of Jesus? Not in Reverend Byrd's name, not in Bill Mountain's name, not in Bishop Reed's name, not in St. Peter's name, but you want to walk in the name of Jesus. You want to walk with authority. You want to walk with power. You want to walk knowing there's healing. You want to walk knowing there's victory. You want to walk in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Look at your name and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Do you want to walk?
Neighbor.
Do you sure not want to walk?
Then
get out the boat. choir coming in with selection.
My Lord, look.
A hymn of invitation.
Thank you, Lord. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
One that remind us by us repenting from our sin.
All right. Thank you.
May we stand. Second verse says to you, if you want to be, if you've been converted, you want to change your way. You want your way to be better than it was yesterday, better than it was before yesterday, better than it was last year. Won't you come now? You want to come there, I want to change my way. I want to grow and be more like Jesus. I want to be more and more like God. Won't you come? Won't you come? Give God a chance and you a chance. Won't you come? Davis family. Won't you come and join us and pray for the Davis family? Maybe you know somebody that's sick in your family. Maybe you're sick. Maybe you're going through some struggle right now. You want to come and say, Lord, I need your help right now. Maybe one of your children, one of your grandchildren is going through something. And you want to pray for them. Maybe you're going through a financial crisis in your life. Maybe you're stressed out. You need the Lord just to step in. Won't you come? Yeah, don't you grab somebody's hand? Grab your neighbor. Grab your neighbor by the hand. Father God, we look to the hill which our help come from. And knowing our help come from you, Lord. Our help come from you, God. We are weak, but thou art strong. We are weak, God. Give us strength, eternal God, that we can stand and walk on the water. No matter where the water may be, that we'll get up and stand up for the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Somebody come praying that their life may be changed. That their life may be changed. That they grow. And that they leave this place called St. Peter. They be better than what it was. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah, somebody. And I'll be better than what I was and when I leave this place. That I can love my neighbor, love my family, love my enemy. That I can love. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. We pray for those who come in time of bereavement. We pray for the Davis family. Strengthen the children, the grandchildren, the great grand.
members of the family, strengthen them. Give them strength to continue to hold on your hand and not lose faith in time of trouble. Thank you, God. Somebody might be sick today. Somebody might be going through a sickness. Somebody might be going through a sickness right now, God. Somebody might be coming in, standing in for a member that who is sick. They want to come and say, Lord, heal that body. Thank you, God. Somebody said, there's power in the name of Jesus. So we claim it with the authority of God that there is power in your name. Now, Lord, we pray for ourselves. Somebody said, Lord, I pray for myself now, Lord. That my soul won't be lost. Woo, hallelujah, Lord, hallelujah. If you were to call me right now, I want to be right. So wash my sins away. Wash my old dirty sins away. Wash them, God, and make me clean all over again.
Thank you, Lord.
So in your name, we claim
it.
We pray that our blessing upon sick people in the church. Lord, we pray that you will just continue to shower your blessing down. Shower your blessing down upon the members of this church. Shower it down, Lord. Shower your blessing down, God. So Lord, we rebuke the devil right now. We rebuke the devil who in the midst right now, trying to call disturbance, trying to call confusion right now, God. We rebuke him right now. And we believe you can do all things. You can do all things, God. You can do all things. So we throw our head back and say, glory. We throw our head back and say, glory. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Why don't you get on your feet? As you step on your feet, if you step on your feet, throw your hands in the air. Throw your hands in the air, wave it like you just don't care. Throw your hands in the air and say, thank you, Lord. Beside you, somebody hug, tell them you love. Tell the person beside, tell them you love, get somebody to hug beside you. Amen.
She don't like me.
Okay, how you doing?
Baby. Church.
tell you something about what I will not do. I don't come in and try to condemn or try to condone anything. I'm 59 years old. My mama had me before she got married. He had my sister before she got married. So anybody looking for somebody perfect.
That's right.
All right now.
And sometimes your children have children.
All right. All right.
And you raise them to take them to somebody else's child.
All right.
So don't never come question me about what's going on. What we need to do is teach folk. Don't question. Teach. Teach. If we teach people, if we teach people, live by example, we live in a better world. But when you try to be holy, and got a skeleton in your clothes. You trying to tell me, not me personally, I'm thinking what I'm saying. I see me wearing short dresses, and all because you can't wear them, but all throughout you get your leg, you can't wear them. Because what time you want short dresses? Try to tell young folk they can't go out at night, and you know we should go out at night now. Here, Barry White.
Watch out.
Amen. All of a sudden, young folk got their own style, so they got their style. We don't like their style. But I don't know, my mama like my style. James Brown, Michael Jackson. So we have to remember where we come from.
Amen. Amen.
That we weren't perfect all of our lives. We were not perfect all of our lives. But somebody prayed for them. Had me on their mind. Took a little time and prayed for me. So if we pray for our children, pray for our nieces, pray for our nephew, we have a much better world to live in. Live by example. Amen. I'll kick it out your hand, because if you come to me, I'm gonna send you back.
Right. I know that's right.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. All our minds clear. Now, next Sunday, I'm gonna take a break. Reverend Buckley gonna preach. You some full Sunday.
Son.
Right, but I know who
you're
talking about.
Say it again, baby.
Buck son.
And your name?
Irish.
Thank you, Sister Irish. Like I say, your book son. We'll be preaching next Sunday. Book son. We'll be preaching next Sunday. We'll rotate. We'll rotate on service for Book Sunday. If I have to preach, I'll preach.
Amen. Amen.
But we'll rotate. Amen.
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 We can't send nobody out there to represent St. Peter if we don't train them.
Amen. Amen. That's right. Come on. That's right. Amen.
Because we ain't going to preach, that's what it represents. Mm-hmm. What church they belong to? They belong to St. Peter. So we have to train.
Amen.
Amen. So, that's the training board.
Mm-hmm.
And then we encourage all preachers, when people invite them to preach, to go preach other places.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
Sometimes it's good to get away from under the wing.
Come on.
Expand yourself. Somebody called them when he preaching, and they called me, I'm going to let them go. They can't sit at home. They can't sit at home. So my job as pastor, also be ministers to them as well. Amen. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
All our minds clear. May we stand. Thank you, Jimmy. You know what the food is ready now? Iris.
No, Pastor Byrd. No.
You're at that point, so I know we are.
I believe in God the Father Almighty.
Maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, the Son of the Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered upon the Father, was crucified, dead and buried, the third day he arose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sits on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Church universal, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Praise God, let's flow, praise Him, our creature of the Lord.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow.
To receive.
Yes.
Let it nourish our body.
Yes.
Wherever needed, dear God.
Yes.
In your precious name we pray. Amen.
Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ rest with the Bible of now, evermore. Let the church, say. Church.